Welcome to the European Parliamentary Research Service podcast on the EU's approach to cyber diplomacy and cyber defence.
Malicious cyber activities pose an increasing threat to our societies, our economies, and our political systems. And no one is safe from virtual, yet very real, attacks.
So what tools does the EU have to respond to such threats, and what is its strategy? Join us in the world of cyberspace.
As society's dependence on the internet grows, so does the number and sophistication of cyber attacks. Estimates suggest that by 2030, there will be 125 billion devices connected to the internet, and 90% of individuals older than 6 years will be online. But such connectivity also gives rise to manifold vulnerabilities.
Indeed, the global cost of cybercrime is estimated at around 530 billion euros, and cyberspace is now officially considered the fifth domain of warfare alongside the traditional sea, land, air and space.
Attacks on critical infrastructure, such as our water management systems, energy grids, key functions that keep a society running, have potential to completely paralyse a country, as witnessed during the 2015 attack on Ukraine's power grid right before Christmas Eve. They can also serve to disrupt electoral processes, as was revealed during the 2016 US presidential election.
As the recent coronavirus pandemic has shown, cybercriminals are also quick to turn a crisis into an opportunity and take advantage of distracted governments to inflict even more damage on the population. In recent months, as the world went into lockdown, cybercriminals targeted critical infrastructures such as hospitals and governmental organizations and took advantage of the millions of people teleworking from unprotected Wi-Fi connections to increase the volume of their attacks.
The World Economic Forum has actually rated cyber attacks on critical infrastructure as the fifth top global risk in 2020. So the question is, what is the EU doing to protect itself and its citizens from new cyber threats? Stay with us.
Since its first cybersecurity strategy was adopted in 2013, the EU has gradually developed cyber ambitions and tools to manage the challenge. And the year 2017 was a landmark one for cyber in the EU with the launch of the Commission's cybersecurity package.
The package included, among other things, a permanent mandate for the EU's cyber agency, an EU cybersecurity certification framework, a blueprint for rapid emergency response, establishing EU-wide cyber research centres, improving law enforcement responses, and improving the overall political response and deterrence.
So one could argue that the EU's response to a sophisticated cyber threat spectrum is comprehensive, but perhaps the most European aspect of its toolbox is cyber diplomacy. Now what is that?
As the ancient Chinese military strategist Sun Tzu once wrote, the supreme art of war is to subdue the enemy without fighting. In the cyber realm, the preferred EU alternative to cyber warfare is diplomacy and cooperation. This aims to secure multilateral agreements on cyber norms and promote responsible state and non-state behaviour in cyberspace and effective global digital governance.
The goal is to create an open, free, stable and secure cyberspace anchored in international law through alliances between like-minded countries, organisations, the private sector, civil society and experts. Therefore, cyber diplomacy coexists with its sister strands of cyber defence, cyber deterrence and cyber security.
And there are some burning issues demanding the international community's attention, including an emerging digital arms race and the need to regulate dual-use export control regimes and clarify the rules of engagement in cyber warfare.
But let's go back to cyber diplomacy. In 2017, the same year the European Commission launched its cybersecurity package, EU member states adopted a cyber diplomacy toolbox. The aim was to set guidelines for malicious cyber activity at all levels, from preventive measures such as capacity building to cooperative measures such as political dialogues, stability measures such as diplomatic engagements, and perhaps most notably, restrictive measures such as travel bans, arms embargoes, freezing of assets.
The guidelines are unambiguous about the security benefits of a joint EU diplomatic response to malicious cyber behaviour. highlighting the deterrent effect upon potential aggressors. It also highlights the need for constant exchanges on the cyber threat landscape and for coordination amongst EU and national actors, even if each member state is free to take its own decisions in this area.
Coordination is key because, as experts often say, you are as strong as your weakest link. This especially applies to countries so deeply interconnected as those in the EU.
Coordination of action with like-minded partners and international organisations is also envisaged, as well as cooperation projects with countries outside the EU's borders, such as the Eastern Partnership countries and countries in West Africa and Southeast Asia.
Some analysts have interpreted the EU's cyber diplomacy action as its intention to position itself as a global force for peace. Let's have a closer look at the global situation.
The urgent need for international cyber statecraft has become increasingly obvious with the fast-paced technological developments occurring worldwide. But while the international cyber policy realm is blessed with a multitude of initiatives, it is at the same time cursed by their fragmentation.
This situation, combined with a growing push for sovereignty in the digital realm, means the race for cyber superiority, if left unchecked, could develop into an even greater security paradox.
However, and despite the fragmented plethora of initiatives, some experts remain optimistic about the deepening multi-stakeholder commitments for upholding an open, safe, and principled cyberspace.
The EU's cyber diplomacy toolbox and its bilateral and multilateral engagements are already contributing to a safer and more principled cyberspace. Its effectiveness, however, hinges on genuine European and global cooperation for the common cyber good. Ultimately, the EU's ambition to become more capable by becoming strategically autonomous or technologically sovereign also rests on credible cyber defence and diplomacy.
You're listening to the European Parliamentary Research Service podcast.